Hi everyone, welcome to Movie Summaries. Today we are summarizing a 2020 psychological thriller movie called Run. Fair warning, there are spoilers in this summary. Enjoy, and be sure to subscribe to watch more videos weekly, and hit like. The movie begins with a group of doctors attempting to save a baby. In another room, the baby's mother, Diane Sherman, is praying to God to save her daughter. The baby survives, who seems to have been born prematurely. A nurse takes Diane to meet her newborn daughter, lying in an incubator surrounded by hospital staff. Diane breaks into tears after seeing her daughter. The little girl is suffering from everything under the sun. Arrhythmia, causing irregular heartbeats. Hemochromatosis, causing rashes and nausea. Asthma, causing difficulty in breathing. Diabetes, causing unstable glucose levels. Paralysis, causing an inability to move. Poor baby. The movie then flashes forward to 17 years later in the future. Diane is at a homeschooling association meeting in Pasco, Washington. So, Diane's daughter survived. They ask Diane how she feels about her daughter, Chloe, going to university. The other parents are emotional about their children going off to college. Diane oddly seems okay. She says she took care of her daughter for 17 years, during which she couldn't travel, go out, and date. But she is happy that Chloe will be able to do that in university. Moreover, Diane reveals that Chloe hasn't heard back from any schools yet. The other parents are surprised by her response. The way these parents are worrying, you would think they're sending their children to war. Diane responds that Chloe is the most capable person she knows, and if there's someone who one shouldn't be worried about, it's her. Okay, proud mama. We get it. Next day, Chloe is finally revealed. She is all grown up, and due to her condition, she uses a wheelchair and a stairlift to move around. She takes a range of pills regularly for her different conditions, and carries an inhaler with her at all times. Diane homeschools her, and she is currently waiting for her university acceptance letters. Every time, the mailman arrives at her door. Chloe rushes to receive the mail, but somehow, every single time, Diane receives the mail before her. Diane is extremely controlling as a mother. She never lets Chloe have more than one chocolate at a time, and she can't step out of the house by herself. She is an aspiring engineer, and she likes to build things in her spare time. Every now and then, after Chloe goes to sleep, Diane sits by herself in the basement and watches old home videos of baby Chloe. Oddly, Chloe seems to be standing just fine in those videos. Also, for some reason, the basement is off limits to Chloe. One day, while looking for a tin of chocolates and a bag of groceries, Chloe finds a bottle of her pills. Oddly, Diane's name is on the label, indicating that they are prescribed to Diane. Later that day, when Diane gives her the same green pill, Chloe asks her why it had her name on it. Diane cleverly changes the topic. When she proceeds to leave, Chloe again presses her about it, and Diane tells her that it was merely the receipt wrapped around the bottle. Chloe takes the pill, but she doesn't seem sold by the explanation. The next day, Chloe makes an equipment to help her reach the top of the cabinet and grab the green pill. Just as she reaches it, she hears the sound of a vehicle approaching. She quickly heads outside and notices that it is a mail van. She rushes to the door, but before she could get to the mail, Diane arrives. She really must be a wizard. Diane tells her that if it's a letter from college, Chloe would be the first one to open it. She doesn't have to race to the door every time to get the mail. Chloe returns to her room and looks at the green pills. The bottle now has a new label, with Chloe's name on it. However, Chloe notices that the new label has been put on top of the old one with Diane's name, which has been partially scraped off, but is still legible enough. Sloppy job. That night, Diane again hands her the pills, but this time, Chloe only pretends to take it and spits it out when Diane leaves. After Diane goes to sleep, Chloe sneaks out of her room to look up the pill's name on her home's only computer. However, she learns that the internet has been disabled. Diane is seen creepily watching Chloe from the other room. The next morning, Chloe hears Diane arguing with someone on the phone. Diane tells her it's the internet service provider, and the internet won't be back until next month. Without being asked, Chloe tells her that she used the computer last night for a project. Smart girl. Even if her mother suspects her, she, nevertheless, covered her tracks. Later, Chloe calls the local pharmacy, and a woman picks up who recognizes Diane's number and asks if it's her. Chloe freaks and quickly ends the call. Next, she decides to use the telephone directory and asks to be connected to a random pharmacy. The AI line reminds her that once connected, a 99-cent charge will be added to the next bill. Chloe definitely doesn't want Diane to see that, so she ends the call again. She then has a plan to call the random local number, and she asks the man on the line to look up the name of the pill online. It is revealed that the drug is taken for heart failure, and that all the pictures of the medication show a small red pill. Chloe is astounded. During dinner, Chloe asks her mother to take her to the movies. Diane agrees, and they go to a movie theater the next day. During the film, Chloe pretends to go to the washroom and rushes to the pharmacy across the street. The pharmacist recognizes Chloe, but refuses to tell her the name of the pill at first because they are under Diane's name. Chloe tells the pharmacist that she wants to know the name of the drug because it's part of a scavenger hunt game. The woman finally agrees to tell her the name, saying it could be a trick question because the drug is called ridocaine, which is only approved for dogs. When Chloe inquires what would happen if a human took the pills, the woman reveals that it could make one's legs go numb. Chloe begins to hyperventilate, and Diane barges into the store. Diane covertly sedates her daughter and takes her home. Diane finally begins to crack. She calls the pharmacist to let her know that Chloe has been acting up under the influence of her new medication. The next day, when Chloe wakes up, she finds herself locked in a room. She calls out for her mother, telling her that she wants to resolve whatever misunderstandings that might have been between them. But she doesn't get any response from her. Realizing that Diane is probably out running errands, she picks the lock, but only to learn that Diane has chained the door. She comes up with another plan. She sneaks out onto the roof from a window and drags herself through the roof to her mother's bedroom window. She then heats up Diane's window with a soldering iron and spits water over it in order to break it. Wow, genius. Einstein who? She then drags herself back into the house through Diane's bedroom. The strenuous exercise causes Chloe to have an asthma attack. She unchains her bedroom and rushes to get her inhaler, barely managing to survive. After catching her breath, quite literally, Chloe then proceeds to head downstairs using the automated wheelchair ramp, but she learns that Diane has cut its power cord. Determined to escape, Chloe throws her wheelchair downstairs before proceeding to drag herself to the bottom. However, she accidentally falls and sustains minor injuries. Chloe learns that she can move one of her toes. She painfully gets back onto the wheelchair and heads outside. On the road, she notices a mail truck and rushes to stop it, jumping literally in front of it. Fortunately, the mail truck stops on time. It is revealed to be Chloe's regular mailman, Tom. She tells him everything that has been happening to her and asks him to take her to the police station. As Tom proceeds to help Chloe board the truck, Diane, who was driving past, notices Chloe's wheelchair and stops her car. Diane attempts to talk to Chloe, but Tom stops her. He tells Diane that Chloe has leveled some serious allegations against her, and she wants to go to the police. Diane tries to explain herself. She says that Chloe has been acting up because of her new medications. When Tom continues to refuse to let Diane talk to Chloe, Diane tries to accuse him of grooming his minor daughter. However, Tom is unfazed by her BS. Diane finally agrees to let Tom take Chloe to the hospital, on the condition that Diane will follow them closely behind in her car. However, when Tom proceeds to close up the van, Diane stabs him with a syringe. Chloe blacks out and later wakes up in her mother's basement. The basement looks like it is Diane's research laboratory, where she comes up with new ways to keep Chloe confined to the house. In the dustbin, Chloe notices all of her college acceptance letters and screams in frustration and anger. On the other side of the basement, she notices a box that says Diane Barronway. She proceeds to wheel towards the box, but she learns that Diane has chained her wheelchair. Chloe, who doesn't let her disability come in the way of her freedom, drags herself towards the box. Inside the box, she comes across childhood photos of herself, where she is seen standing and running on her 2 feet. She also comes across a death certificate of a girl named Chloe, who died 2 hours after birth. Chloe also recovers a clipping of an article about a couple who had their baby stolen from the same hospital. It turns out, this girl is not Diane's biological daughter, Chloe. Chloe breaks into tears. Wow, holy crap. So Diane stole a baby. When Diane comes to the basement, Chloe confronts her about everything, telling Diane that she isn't her real mom. Diane tells her that everything she ever did was to help her, and she claims that no one loves their child more than she does. Chloe accuses her of poisoning her, but the delusional woman interrupts her and tells her that she protected her. Diane throws the pills and asks to start over with Chloe. However, when Chloe refuses to accept her, Diana loses it and starts mixing paint thinner. Chloe freaks out and asks her what she is doing, but Diane ignores her. Chloe asks her not to do something that she will regret later, but Diane continues and fills a syringe with the paint thinner. Frightened, Chloe retreats and locks herself in the closet. Diane asks her to open the door and tells her that what she is doing is right for her. Yeah, right. She tells Chloe not to be scared or cry, claiming she would never hurt her. Diane tells her that the paint thinner is going to make Chloe forget everything, and when she wakes up, Diane will be right by her side. She will be her baby forever. This woman has lost it. Chloe suddenly notices chemicals on the shelf and comes with an idea. Hearing Chloe grab the bottles, Diana looks for the keys to the closet. Chloe has grabbed herself a bottle of organophosphate, which can be fatal to humans. Just as Diane opens the door, Chloe tells her that she needs her and drinks the chemical. Diane loves her and will not let her die. Chloe starts coughing blood while Diane screams in frustration and anger. The plan works, and Diane rushes Chloe to the hospital. Chloe wakes up in the hospital bed, intubated and barely able to move. Meanwhile, Diane is talking to Chloe's doctor and nurse. They tell her that although Chloe's condition is now stable, patients who attempt suicide as an adolescent are considered high-risk patients who must be evaluated by a mental health physician before discharged. Later, when Chloe sees Diane outside, she starts panicking. She summons all her strength to signal the nurse that she wants to say something. The nurse understands her and brings Chloe a notebook and a crown. People with suicidal tendencies are only allowed to use crowns for safety reasons. Just as Chloe finishes writing the letter M, an alarm starts going off, and the nurse is forced to rush outside. Diane sneaks into the room and ties Chloe to a wheelchair to take her home. As Diane heads toward the exit, the nurse returns to Chloe's room to find her missing. On her bed, the nurse finds Chloe's notebook saying, "Mom." The nurse realizes that Diane kidnapped Chloe and alerts the security. Panicking, Chloe pulls out a gun and tries to find an exit. Chloe places her foot on the floor to stop the wheelchair from moving and keeping Diane from taking her away. Diane pleads with her to come home with her, but Chloe defiantly replies that she doesn't need her. The psychopathic Diane then frighteningly announces that she will. However, she then gets surrounded by the security and shot in the arm, causing her to fall down the stairs. Chloe watches it transpire in disbelief from the top of the stairs as a nurse tends to her. 7 years pass by, and adult Chloe is seen going to a correctional facility. Although she uses a wheelchair to move around, she can walk short distances with the use of a cane. She visits someone in the infirmary wards and tells them about her lovely husband and little daughter Amy, who is just learning to walk. As Chloe talks about her job, it is revealed that Chloe is talking to Diane, who is sick and bedridden. Chloe tells her that now it is time to go, and takes out 3 plastic-wrapped ridocaine pills she hid under her tongue. She tells Diane that she still loves her, before asking her to open her mouth wide open. Sheesh, what a storyline. Glad Diane got caught. Hope you enjoyed our summary. Make sure to like, subscribe, comment, and turn on notifications so you can watch more videos weekly. Thanks.